All right, so I did contact the lower court, and not because I was doing anything, not the lower court, the higher court, but not because I was doing anything special. The young lady was very receptive and very good to me. I spoke to her previously, and it was just because I guess she understood how I felt. You could probably hear it in my voice. The recruiter could hear it in my voice when I talked to her. And basically, she sent me, they don't have any information there at all. When they have the case number, they just have the case number and whatever I had. That's it. They don't have any information. She said I had to go to the circuit court. Well, again, the thing about the runaround, because now that I think about it, she told me they didn't have any information at all, but she was the one that read to me the document that I was looking at the last time. So I just. And again, it's because they don't want to have any burden. So she sent me back to the lower court again. She said it was the circuit court, which is the same number that I had for the lower court. It sends you through this phone tree. They tell you to put in the case number. I put in the case number. They give me some information from back in 1970, 70. I wasn't even around in 1970, literally. And then I was like, okay, well, maybe they want not the lower case number, but the higher case number. So I put the higher case number in, and it's still reading it as if it's the lower case number. So it's gonna be a whole lot of runaround, and I'm gonna tell y'all right now. That's the part that's really stressful to me because that woman has some information, but I guess she's saying that for me to get a final disposition, I have to go to the circuit court, which I guess is the same as the lower court. I don't know. But obviously, I'm gonna need my day tomorrow because I'll be in somebody's court all day tomorrow, talking to somebody, trying to meet somebody, do something. So I just, I have to think well about this because, I mean, like I said, the majority of people are idiots. If you read it, it'll show that they're, it doesn't say that that's what happened. And I guess. Yeah, so that's what I need to do. I need to go to go there. But as y'all know, I'm like making it check to check. So that's kind of funny. That'll be a neat trick. So, but God works in funny ways, so it might happen. It might happen. And then the person that said they were gonna take me before, I think. After a while, like I said, other people are gonna see it as a negative, but it's a situation, and I have to work through it. You know what I'm saying? And that's a positive is that you're working through it. And so after hearing about all the struggles with the jobs, after hearing about all the struggle, and then the additional struggle of having to go all the way to Miami, and then probably the lower court is gonna tell me to go to the higher court, the higher court is gonna tell me to go to the lower court, and it's just gonna be they're gonna toss me back and forth like a ping pong. And I'm not going to get anything accomplished. And it hurts. It hurts because, and then, who wants to journey on that with me? You know what I'm saying? This person said that they would, but that was probably in the moment. You know what I mean? That was in the moment. It is going to be a lot of back and forth. And then I've also discussed with them some of the other issues that I have regarding the employment thing. So they've probably had enough. They don't want to hear any more about that. You know what I'm saying? They don't, I'm not a relative of theirs, a family member, a friend. I'm not a none of those things, and so they don't want to, participate in that. They may not say it directly, but I mean it's kind of obvious. So I mean I just so my thing is that I just have to go back. But then if I go back, it's like I don't know. Like I said, right now it's like check to check. So I'm just exhausted by the whole thing, And the living situation, the job thing, the legal thing, right now the way that it feels is it's just exhausting, And I need to turn it around. I need to somehow turn it all around. And it can be done. It can be done. I mean, it can be done. I just have to change my attitude and spirit about it. And that's what, again, like I said, the whole purpose of this is the effects of the legal system. It wears you down. After years and years of, You're fighting even things that you're not really fighting. You know what I'm saying? You're court ordered to homelessness. So you're fighting, you know, you're being put into a situation that you're not even familiar with. You know what I mean? And then after a while, in order for you to be get respected at that level, you have to pretend like you're familiar with that situation. So you pick up mannerisms and habits that are of those certain groups of people. You know, the ghetto, the sad, all of that, you know, you pick up those habits and then you're forced to do other things like the improper eating. And, you know, so it's just, it becomes a part of you, you know, and, you know, I don't want to continue to expose myself to that, you know, so I don't. And my biggest thing is vindictive people, you know, people that will say and do anything, you know, people that are untruthful and dishonest. So it's just, you know, I feel like at my age now, I feel like I should be in semi-retirement. At this age, you should have stabilized your career. And basically, you're in semi-retirement because all you're doing is going through the process and you're just chilling. You're just waiting out for the next 20 years so that you can retire, you know. So I'm just, I don't know. But like I said, sometimes, you know, God has a bigger plan, you know. And because I believe that we all exist and are created for a purpose. And when we're not serving our purpose, that's when we come across, you know, friction in our lives. So there's a purpose that I need to serve. There was information that I need to know, you know, about life and living and about different types of people. And that's why I was exposed to that. And, wow. I mean, there's nothing I can do at this point. The higher court has told me to go to the lower court. The lower court, I can't get in contact with anybody. Nobody ever answers the phone. You push in the buttons, they tell you the absolute incorrect information. And, you know, there's nothing else I can do with that. But there's other stuff that I can do in life in general. So my next step now is to see what resources I can get to help me out in different ways. So that's my next step. And I'm about to do that right now. I don't want to, but because that's another hurdle that I have to cross. So. I don't know. I have some decisions to make right now, you know, as far as, you know, my living situation. I have decisions to make about, I do need, you know, some resources. So that's just what it is. And yeah. So that's the update. So I just have decisions. This is where I am right now, is in a turning point of, you know, finding resources. And about my living situation. So those are the next two steps that I need to kind of address. So again, we're going to say a prayer. Dear God, please give me the wisdom and guidance to approach these issues professionally, personally, wisely, with strength and wisdom, Lord. And again, helping me to keep my status of honesty and integrity. And please, Lord, give me, again, strength, courage, and wisdom in walking through this process. Lord, help me to take steps that are good for me, not just, you know, trying to appease everybody, because I've tried that, and really it just ends up in me being badgered a little more because they know that I'm trying to appease them. So, God, please help me to take these steps wisely. And please, again, put me into good spirits with every person that I come upon so that they are more than willing to help. I want to say thank you to the lady that did the recruiting for job number one. She was absolutely wonderful. She tried her best. Had I done exactly what she told me to do, I probably would not have had a rescinded offer. It's just that I didn't have the financial resources to do it. I mean, as simple as that. You know, I barely had enough to make my chicken soup, my soup, or whatever, to last me for days and days and days. So, you know, and I wanted to, in good faith, supply something. And she did try to advise me of different things. And, yeah, so I need to make, you know, some moves. And I also want to say amen. But when I woke up this morning, the other feeling that I got was that I needed to start, you know, because I am cold, you know, looking at other options. And I guess it's all coming together that that's what needs to be done. I think I was pulled from that environment for a reason. Like I said, I saw some very different things going on down there, but I guess God is trying to replace me now. So we'll see what happens. I definitely do need some assistance. So I'm going to see what I could do, you know, about getting that. And that's it. That's it. I don't know what's going to happen from there. So that's where it is. I don't know. I just have to use wisdom in it, you know. Like I said, it's about the location. I don't know what I'm going to do about that. And then the assistance. I mean, I guess at this point with the assistance, I don't know. I'm going to try to call and see what happens. But anyways, bye.